Citizenship by birth, giving your child and potentially you and your wife, girlfriend, or if you're the wife and girlfriend, giving you and your spouse a second citizenship, essentially for free by giving birth in another country. We recently had one of our clients in the private community say, "My wife is pregnant. I just found out 4 days ago, and we're considering giving birth in another country." They are from Nigeria, and from all different countries around the world, we get this specific request. From Americans, from Canadians, from Nigerians, from Indians. We want to give birth in another country. We want to use this opportunity of having a child or multiple children to get ourselves a second passport. So where should you do it? And also, where is it risky to do it? Because I can tell you to go give birth in Mexico, but Mexico, really? Giving birth there? What if the child dies? Do they speak English? What's really going on in that place? And what's also the infant mortality rate, which is a rate where you should, if you're having children, consider when picking a country to have that child, because it depends on the level of healthcare, how many children die after being born, and how many women die after giving birth. Now, the most common, most popular countries are going to be Mexico, Argentina, Brazil, and then the last one is going to be Chile, which a bit tricky. I'll explain how to get Chilean citizenship in a bit. It is the best citizenship out of these four because you have access to the US, you also have Mercosur, you also have a pretty well-developed place, although danger is increasing. It's not as safe as it was before, but it's a pretty stable country. Mexico is the most popular. A lot of our clients, and specifically a lot of Americans, go to Mexico, and there are specialized clinics already for citizenship in Mexico. There's specialized clinics that all speak English in Baja California Sur, Quintana Roo, Mexico City, Yucatan. There's many different clinics all over the country that specialize in giving birth for foreigners. You can go there with your girlfriend or wife. Your girlfriend or wife can give birth there. Obviously, you need to travel, usually before the third trimester. So you need to travel before she's going to go into labor. Usually, airlines are not going to let you even get into another country that late on in a pregnancy, so you have to plan out a couple months in advance. You can book a full consultation package. You can book a birth package. It's going to cost you a couple $1,000s. In some cases, in the best clinics, around $10,000, $15,000. They're going to make sure that your wife or girlfriend is taken care of, that your child is born properly, that everything is done in English, that everything is clean. You are not giving birth in a public hospital. That is why when you see the infant mortality rate in Mexico, which is very high, almost 13 deaths per 1,000 live births, that is because the country is massive and a lot of people live in villages and a lot of people are poor. So it doesn't mean that your child is going to die because they're born in Mexico. It just means that in general, giving birth in Mexico is not as safe as giving birth in Europe. Many European countries, for example, or even giving birth in Canada is a lot safer in general. But if you pay the price, your child gets instant citizenship. Being born in Mexico, that citizenship can never be taken away. And now they are originally Mexican, which means that they are now entitled to, for example, Spanish citizenship in just 2 years of living in Spain. Let's say you are a US citizen and your wife or girlfriend is Russian or any other nationality, and then the child is born Mexican. Now they have 3 passports that they can choose from. And if they want, on top of that, get a European citizenship, they can go and live in Spain later on in their life. And they can also get their 4th passport as a European. So you're really prepping them up for the perfect life with as many opportunities as possible. And you, as the parent and as the parents, you get permanent residency in Mexico and citizenship after 2 years. You do need to live in Mexico at least 18 months during those 2 years. So prepare to actually live in Mexico during that time. You're obviously going to stay a couple of months after the child is born, not travel immediately. And then you can also apply for citizenship yourself and your girlfriend or wife. So essentially you're giving your whole family citizenship. You're not paying a huge amount. You're paying 10, 15K for that. You're getting amazing treatment, amazing healthcare, and an amazing citizenship that you can use in the future. The second most popular country is Argentina. Now, this one specifically has been made popular by a lot of Russians. A lot of Russian women over the last 2 years, essentially, have been visiting Argentina during their pregnancy and giving birth in Argentina. It became global news when a lot of Russian women were actually detained at the Buenos Aires airport trying to get into the country during their pregnancy to give birth, to give their children Argentinian citizenship. So it's a big deal. And Argentina will probably not change this law. It's citizenship by birth. So if you give birth in Argentina, your child is automatically an Argentinian citizen. The same thing that happens in Mexico with these clinics, and they treat you all in English and in some cases in Russian, actually. So if you speak Russian and you want to give birth in Argentina, you can actually find a Russian-speaking clinic in Argentina that will help you give birth, get citizenship for your child, and citizenship for you too. It's that popular. The same as in Mexico for Americans. Argentina works in the same way, where the child is automatically Argentinian. They are also born Argentinian, so they can also apply for Spanish citizenship after 2 years. And the great thing about Argentina is that you can immediately apply for citizenship as the parent. You don't need to wait the 2 years that you need to wait for Mexico. You just give birth, and then a couple of weeks later, literally, you can apply for citizenship, and the whole family can get Argentinian passports. You can then leave Argentina. You don't have to live in Argentina for the next couple of years, and then continue traveling around the world, continue getting other passports, and so on. The infant mortality rate in general in Argentina is lower than Mexico at 8.4 deaths per 1,000 live births. So it is statistically safer to give birth in Argentina than it is in Mexico. But again, you're giving birth in a private clinic, English speaking, amazing healthcare, with great doctors that are probably trained in the West. They were trained in the US or in Europe. They were not trained in Argentina. The third country is Brazil, right next to Argentina, also part of Mercosur. It's if you give birth in Brazil, then your child is automatically Brazilian. And they also have expedited residency to Portugal. You, as the parent, get permanent residency, like in the case of Mexico, and can apply for citizenship after 1 year of living in Brazil. That's the only problem. In some cases, it is allowed to apply beforehand. If your child is born in Brazil and you stay a while in Brazil, you don't need to wait the whole year to apply for citizenship. But in most cases, it's going to be 1 year, and you also get your Brazilian passport. The great thing about Brazil, although they're having issues with Twitter X and Elon Musk, and they're restricting freedoms, and they're restricting freedom of speech, which a lot of people obviously hate and I don't agree with. So a lot of people are not choosing Brazil. They're choosing other countries. One great thing about Brazil is that they do not extradite their citizens. So if for any reason your child gets into any problem around the world, they will not be extradited from Brazil to the country that wants them. If that's important to you, then you might consider Brazil as an option. But many countries around the world don't actually extradite their citizens. Those countries, mainly in Latin America, will never extradite somebody unless it's to the US for some sort of drug charge or something like that. And the fourth most popular country, which is, it's a tricky one, to be honest, to give birth in, it's a tricky one to get residency, to then get citizenship for you as a parent, and that is Chile. Chile has an interesting law where you need to be a resident for 1 year before giving birth for the child to be born a Chilean. So you and your girlfriend or wife need to be residents in Chile for the year prior of the birth for the child to have a Chilean passport. So what can you do? You can get pregnant, get a medical certificate, and then apply for what's called a humanitarian visa, sometimes called a pregnancy visa, literally. You can apply for this pregnancy visa and then get a 1 year visa to go to Chile. You go to Chile and you are now a resident for 1 year, meaning that when you give birth, the child is automatically Chilean. They can also apply for Spanish citizenship after 2 years. They get a solid passport and all those good things about being born in Spanish-speaking Latin America. And also, you as the parent don't need to wait the 5 years to apply for citizenship. In some cases, you need to wait 1 to 2 years to apply for Chilean citizenship. This is tricky. In some cases, these are rejected. So it's not that in the case of Brazil or Argentina or Mexico, you can wait that amount, apply, and then 100% get approved. It's depending on who is approving your application. Your child will most likely be Chilean by birth, but you will, it depends on the application, depends on your original nationality, it depends how long you're actually spending in Chile during that period after the birth, it depends what ties you have to Chile, if you have real estate, if you have banking, if you have companies in Chile. But Chile does have an interesting tax option where you don't need to pay any taxes on any foreign source income for 3 years, extendable to 6 years. It's actually pretty hard to extend to 6 years. And the residency in Chile is pretty helpful if, for example, a world war breaks out. You can choose Chile and be pretty much as far away as possible from everything else. Tricky, but if you really want it, it's possible. And also the infant mortality rate is 5.7 deaths per 1,000 births. So it's much safer statistically to give birth in Chile than it is in Mexico, Brazil, or Argentina. And now two more countries that nobody really considers to give birth in, to give their child and themselves a second passport, and that is Portugal and Spain. Portugal has a law where if you are a resident 1 year before the birth, just like Chile, your child gets Portuguese citizenship. Now, unfortunately, you get nothing. But if you're planning on giving birth anyway in the next, let's say, 2 to 3 years, then it might be wise to get Portuguese residency or a Portugal golden visa. And then in a year, you give birth and your child will be born Portuguese. They have a Portuguese passport, they have an EU passport, and now you don't really need to worry about them having a great passport. Maybe you give them your nationality, maybe you're an American, your wife, girlfriend is from whatever country, and now you give them 3 passports, including an EU passport, and the child is born in a pretty safe country statistically to be born in. The infant mortality rate is only 2.8 deaths per 1,000 births, so it's twice as safe to give birth in Portugal than it is in Chile, for example. It's a beautiful place, it's a calm place, some areas are a bit sketchy, but in general, our clients tend to like Portugal. And I mentioned Spain. Spain has an interesting law where if you are born in Spanish territory, you have to live in Spain 1 year only instead of the usual 10 years for most people to get citizenship. So if you're an American, or let's say a couple where they're both Americans, they get residency in Spain, or they don't even need to get residency in Spain, they just can give birth. Better if you get residency, let's say Spanish golden visa, Spanish retirement visa, you give birth in Spain, that child now, born in Spain, can live in Spain 1 year, let's say you live the year after birth, and they are entitled to Spanish citizenship instead of waiting the usual 10 years. You as a parent, unfortunately, get nothing, although it does help in your future citizenship application. Let's say you start living in Spain for 10 years, or in some cases less, you can say that you have a child born in Spain that is already a Spanish citizen, you have property in Spain, you have companies in Spain, banks in Spain, which I don't really recommend tying yourself too much to Spain. It's a tricky place, but it does help in your future citizenship application. There is just no law that says, oh, if you have a child in Spain, you can wait 2 years instead of the 10. No, only your child gets citizenship. And out of all of these that we've been talking about, Spain is statistically the safest country to give birth in. The quality of healthcare, in my experience in Spain, is top. And there are a lot of Swedish people, Baltic people, Polish people that give birth in Spain, and their children also acquire Spanish citizenship. If you're interested in getting a second passport for you and your family, you definitely want to watch this video right here on Caribbean citizenships, tax-free Caribbean passports. Are they worth it? I have one. I spent 150 grand getting it. It took me 6 months. You want to learn all about them, the requirements, and are they still worth it at higher prices? Check them out right here.